Grazie. कैमरा कितनी है तो हम रिव्यूजिंग भी लैपटॉप से हम देख के बताओ उसी से पढ़ेंगे। इंट्रोडक्शन एवं सितम एकम समय भगवा सावर्थ्यम विगरति जेत वन्य अनाथ पिंडित सत आराम क्लियर है वैसा प्रेमा कुछ और तत्को भगवा तू आमन आमन तेसी सोचेस आमन किसे भी कहा there the Lord said this to the bhikkhus. What did he say? Bhikkhavoti, O bhikkhus.
Vadante dite, vadante dite hu, bhagavato bachasosun.
Vato bachasosun, bhagava etan bhocha.
Bhocha.
So, vadante dite means one grace, vulnerable sir. The bhikkhus, bachasosun means responded. Replied in response, yes, Lord. Bhagava etat vocha. Buddha spoke this. Then what did he speak, Peter?
Chatuhi bhikkhave angehi samannagata vacha subhasita hoti na dubhasita anvajya cha
चतुही चतुही चार भिक्खवे अंगे ही अंगों से समन्नागता एंडोर्ड विद वाचा सुभाषिता होती बाय व्हेन इट इज एंडोर्ड विद दीस फोर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स देन द वर्ड्स आर वेल स्पोकन न दुभाषित नॉट विल स्पोकन अनवज्ज थॉटलेस च अनवज्जा च विन्यूनम एंड द विन्यूनम इज वाइज पीपल डोंट क्रिटिसाइज इट डोंट सेंसर इट कथम ही चतुरी विच फोर देन यू रिस्पॉन्स विच फोर इट एल्स
इत भिक्खवे भिक्खु सुभाषी चिंतय
भासितम येव
सुभाषितम येव भासति नो दुभासितम धम्यम धम्ययेव भासित भासति नो अधम्यम पियम येव भासति नो अपियम संच येव सच्चम सच्चि
सच्चम
सच्चम येव भासित भासति नो अलिकम
से क्या कहते हैं इद भिक्खवे भिक्खु ओ भिक्खुस भिक्खु सुशाब्द सुभाषितम एव भासति सो द भिक्खु स्पीक्स वेल स्पोकन लैंग्वेज नो दुभाषितम नॉट इल स्पोकन व्हेन धम्मेव भासति व्हेन स्पीक व्हिच इज राइटियस व्हिच इज वर्दी नो अधम्मम एंड नॉट व्हिच इज अनवर्दी प्रियम एव भासति नो अप्रियम व्हाट इज प्लेजेंट नॉट व्हाट इज अनप्लेजेंट सच्चम एव भासति नो अलिकम ही स्पीक्स व्हाट इज ट्रू नॉट व्हाट इज फॉल्स इमे ही को भिक्खवे चतुर्ही अंगे ही समन्नागता वाचा सुभाषिता होती नो दुभाषिता अनवज्जा च अनन्वज्जा च विन्योति सो नीड वर्ड्स व्हिच आर स्पोकन एंड ऑल ऑफ दीस four characteristics are well spoken and not ill spoken and not censored by the words. This question number 452 is just above that. Idam bhocha bhagava idam batvana suvatu attaparam etad bhocha satta. This is what the Suvata said. And He went on to say further, he said this. So in the verse, the group is 452. This is the verse.
Subhashitam Utta Namaham
Ahu
Uttam Namaho Santo Dhammam Bhante Nadadham
Nadhammam
Nadhammam Tam Duttiyam Piyam Bhante
Bhane Bolna
Piyam Bhane Napiyam Tam
Tatiyam.
This
is the third.
Satcham Bhane Nalikham Tam
Chatuttham
Chatuttham
Titi. ये चार किनारे हैं। सुभाषितम उत्तमम आहु संतो सेंट से दी वेल स्पोकन लैंग्वेज इज उत्तम बेस्ट इज फॉरमोस्ट धम्मम भने स्पीकिंग व्हाट इज वर्थी और व्हाट इज राइटियस ना अधम्मम तम दुखी एंड व्हाट इज नॉट वर्थ अनवर्थी स्पीकिंग दैट इज द सेकंड पार्ट फर्स्ट वन द सेकंड थर्ड इज PM Bhanne, speaking what is Kriya, what is pleasant. Na PM, this is not unpleasant. This is the third. Satcham Bhanne, speaking the truth. Nalikam Tam Chatuttham, not, which is not true. That is the fourth. So these are the four characteristics of good speech, well spoken words. Atapo Ayasma Bhangi So Uthaya Asana. एकम सम चीवरम कत्वा येन भगवा येन अंजलिं प्रणमयित्वा भगवन्तम् एतद् वचनम् याद आपको वंगीस पहले भी आया था देन द एनरेबल वंगीसा उत्थासायम गेटिंग अप फ्रॉम हिज सीट एकम सम चीवरम कत्वा एंड पुटिंग हिज रोब ऑन वन साइड ऑन शोल्डर Yena Bhagava, where the Lord was, then Anjalim Panametva, then with folded hands, Bhagavantam Ethan Vocha. Then he spoke this to the Lord. Patibhati Mam Bhagava, Patibhati Mam Sura. I wish to speak something. I want to. Something is coming to my mind. So the Lord says, Patibhati Tam Mandisa. Go ahead, Bhagava. Mandisa, speak. Then this is what he speaks.
अथ को आयस्मा वंदीसो भगवंतं सम्मुखा सारु
वंदीसा भगवंतं सम्मुखा स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ बुद्धा सारु उपाही अप्रोप्रिएट गाथाई वर्सेस उत्थावी ही प्रेज द बुद्धा विद बी अप्रोप्रिएट वर्सेस सो देन ही सेज दीज वर्ड्स टू प्रेज द बुद्धा
तमेव वाचम भाष्य यायत्तानं न तापय परिच न हिंसेय सावे वाचा सुभाषितम्
तमेव वाचम भाष्य लेट वन स्पीक सच वर्ड्स यायत्तानं न तापय बाय व्हिच यू डू नॉट कॉज अ हर्ट पेन टू योरसेल्फ परिच न हिंसेय एंड दूसरे को भी हिंसा नहीं करते Savi Vata Subhasana. Such words are truly well spoken.
So, this is one
Vangisa is not saying. It is saying in a verse.
Piya Vachemva Vaseya Ya Vacha Pati Nantita Yam Anadaya Apani Paresam भासते प्रियम
प्रियम प्रियम मतलब प्रिय प्रियम चवेव भाषे लेट वन यूज प्लेजेंट वर्ड्स ये या वाचा पटिनंदिता दैट विच मेक्स अदर्स हैप्पी ये माना दिया पापानी एंड वी कीप अवे फ्रॉम इविल स्पीच परेशम भासते प्रियम लेट वन स्पीक व्हाट इज प्लीजिंग टू अदर्स देन ही सेज सच्चं वा अमता वाच एष धम्मो सनातनो सच्चे अर्थे च धम्मे च आहु संतो वदिष्यतः सो ट्रूली इज एष धम्मो सनातनो इज eternal, this is the eternal Dhamma, this is the eternal truth. What is it? Satyam ma amata vacha. The truth is verily like a modern speech. Satye athe cha dhamme cha cha ahu santo patipta. Those good people who are well established in truth, welfare and virtue, they say such things. They are well established, the good people are well established in satya, dharma and...
He is not asking a question.
Not asking question. He is saying, I want to say something.
Right.
He said, I want to say something. You will see, last word will tell you. You know, why it is he wanting to say. Last word. Yam buddho bhasati vacham themam nimbana patya dukkhasya antaka viryaya saveva vachanam uttama. And the words which the Buddha speaks, themam nimbana patya, which are short leap to nimbana, dukkhasanta kariya, which are going to end to suffering, sa ve vacham anuttam. Such words are really meaningless. This is the only one that is said. Sivasita suttam and mithyakam. That is the end of this small sutta. So the emphasis is being given on speaking truth.
Speaking, not hurting others by speech. There were four things, no? One was present, other was truth.
Well spoken. First part is just that, which is well spoken, not ill spoken.
So Sudhakar is just saying that why are the numbers different in Pali and the Sanskrit?
This is because Pali is taken from VRI. Translation is taken from other sources. So there are these mismatch of numbers. Translation is taken from the Postcards translation, PPS edition. PPS edition may or may not be a mismatch. Ek do shikti gal gal ho gaya. Ek do verses jo hai na, continuously aisa hai sometimes.
One is well spoken, the other is one is what is worthy.
What is righteous, what is worthy, what is not unworthy.
So another would be the just generally gupshap.
Criticizing the will not tell lies, will not slander, will not gossip, will not say harsh words. That's the kind of word. Not a shield we have. We saw all the way in the middle of the shield. Sorry, this one I watch the way in the middle of the shield. So here we are advised to speak the truth and speak it in a pleasant manner. Any other question? So let us move further. So today we will complete the fundamentals. This section as Abhidhamma for meditator. This is the fundamentals. So till now we have studied Chitta, Chetsika. Now we will study Abhidhamma. So this fundamental issue is here. Completed, then we'll come to the application of these. Of course, partly we have discussed application along with it, but then we'll focus more on the application. So the matter of the rupa is generally divided into 28 dhammas. Next question. So these are the 28 dhammas. Out of these, actually 18 are dhammas and 10 are their characteristics. So they are not treated as ultimate dhammas. They are treated as nominal dhammas. So because of the special characteristic of rupa, which is a matter.
So what are the, they are called concretely produced matter, basic matter. They are the four great elements which we have already known. Then there are four corresponding objective phenomena, which are listed in number three. Then five sensitivity, that is five organs of sense.
So five disciplines?
The organs of sense.
Organs of sense. Then objective phenomena जो great elements के साथ हैं चार ही हैं हालांकि पांच sensitivity हैं वो चार ही हैं we don't know why they are four only they should have been five then there is the gender then the heart life and nutrition इसने यहाँ पे phenomena translate किया हुआ है you can call it dhamma also महाभूतास सागरूपास and objective phenomena And there are 10, these are attributes of the previous 18 concrete produced matter. So they are not treated as ultimate realities, but for the sake of understanding, they are helpful. So there it is called the space element, then the communication elements, bodily intimation, verbal intimation, then the phenomena which are to give the flexibility to the body, and the basic four characteristics of arising and passing. They are also treated as dhammas. Initial production, then maintenance, then decay, and importance. So this is how the whole categories of matter can be visualized.
So intimation kya?
Yeah, communication. Intimation kya? Communication ke liye jaise humko aap se baat karni hai. So there's a facial communication, then there's verbal communication. Or is getting bodily communication and verbal communication. So we will then move on to the next.
See, lightness, malleability, they are not.
वहाँ पे आए थे ना mind में भी, they were mental similar characteristics were in the mind. So they were mental characteristics. Now they are bodily characteristics. Body में भी रहती है lightness, flexibility. So let's study one by one. So firstly, the word term rupa comes from the word rupati. It means the forms. So Buddha, when he is asked to give a definition of rupa, he says that which deforms. So deforms by various means, by heat, by cold, by illness, by weather, and so on. So this is all the main characteristic of them. Fundamental characteristic is that they consist of four great elements, which are called Mahabhutas. We have already studied about them number of times. Or dhatu, there mahabhuta, there earth, water, fire, and wind. Prithvi dhatu, apo dhatu, agni dhatu, tejo dhatu, and vayu. There these are kind of primary building blocks of matter. Just as we talk of quarks and so on, they talk of these because this is what we can experience. And what we can experience solidity, we can experience cohesion, we can experience temperature, we can experience movement. So that's how these. Then we come to one by one each of those elements. So earth element is you remember we should remember those characteristics. These are not entities, they are experiences, and those experiences are given a name like that. So the characteristic of earth element is extension, right? It occupies space, and that is in primary kind of.
I thought earth element meant hardness.
Yeah, that is the main element of extension. The main characteristics are hardness. The secondary characteristics include softness, smoothness, roughness, heaviness, lightness, which we feel in our body at various points. And which we feel in touching others and lifting others. Bharat bharipan lagta hai, khurdrapan hoga ya, smooth hogi ya. That kind of properties come under. So the you remember that sutta, maha rahuloha sutta, so this is from there. Whatever in our body is hard, solid, rough or soft, such as head, hair, teeth, nails, bones, heart, spleen, has this element as its predominant factor. But other also are present, all the four are always present. And it is not the proportion of it which is, but the intensity. So the In things which are solid, earth element has the largest intensity. And excess of earth element in the body will cause hardness, rigidity, and then it is related to the diseases of arthritis, cardiovascular diseases and so on, because the second body is stiff. So this is the characteristic of earth element. Then we move on to water element or the apodhatu. This is a bit tricky because this is not something which you can experience. It is derived by inference. Because if you say, you know, it says said to be have a characteristic of flow or cohesion. Basically, it's cohesion. You say, aata rakh lo, paani dal do, to aata ke cheeze bidhad jaati hai na, wo ghus jata hai. Mitti mein dal do, wo ghus jayega. Zyada dal doge to behna shuru. That is the way it is recognized. It provides the binding force for other elements. But if it is excess, then it will display the characteristic of flow. Or if the water element is not there, the things will not hold together. They just disintegrate. And so it is said when it is in balance, the other elements go here. When it is in excess, they disperse and flow. So whatever is in the body is of the nature of fluid is matter. It's the nature of water element, urine, blood, and so on, all the things which flow. So this is how the water element is defined. The trouble is that you cannot experience it. If you take water, put your hand, either you feel its temperature, or you feel that it is soft, you can't feel that it is cohesive or it is flowing. That is by inference. So you derive this by inference. The integrity of the element of any body as matter is kept by hot water element. Otherwise, it just disperses. So this is the way they are understood. When we have fire element, you know,
so in our modern science, the material can remain intact because of the
molecular
top of force. So, how does earth remain intact? From this perspective, is because water,
yeah. According to this perspective, it remains any matter, mountains, they are intact because there is water. It is for water element and keeping them bound together. So, nowadays we talk of endomolecular forces, but they are not experienced as just concepts. This is what you can experience, that's the beauty of it. So, people don't say it is useless. And the Purani baat hai, aisa nahi. This is an experience even now. Then the fire element is the characteristic of heat and cold, which we all know. We recently experienced it. And the characteristic of it is that it ripens, matures, digests the food, then get transmitted. And when we eat the food, you know, the body starts getting heated up and all that. So it also manifests as suppleness. Say iron bar ko aap garam karo, khub garam karo, to supple ho jata hai. So that also is another characteristic. And if it is cold, then things become rigid. So another name for it is Utu. Utu means climate in terms of temperature. So when we say that cold is also Tejo Dhatu, it means the intensity of Tejo Dhatu being very low, then it manifests as cold. So cold and hot are relative terms. Examples from DV and notes from now. During summer season, when people enter the shade, having first stayed in the sun, then they feel cold. Because relatively speaking, it is there.
So, Sudhakar had this question that I thought all the elements are defined as that we can experience.
Yeah.
Why an inference is treated as an element?
Yeah. Because they say it is seen. There is a ability of coherence that is seen. Jaise mitti mein pani dal do to gir jati hai, kisi bhi matter mein dal, so that is seen. So the probably the seers were not able to figure out how the matter is cohering, and they found out from their own observation. It is not a direct experience but observation. So that way
It is defined in them. That's why the matter is defined in a different manner. This is one property which cannot be experienced directly. Cohesion cannot be experienced directly because of the nature of the senses. The senses are such limited that they, when you put your hand, you can get temperature of the water, or you can feel it is soft, and will go into it.
But you can feel it's flow.
You can't feel. You can. Flow is a concept. So when you see the, for example, flow of sensations, it is a concept. Actually, they are arising, passing away in such a manner, just like neon signs. We see a flow in neon signs. It is a concept. So they penetrated that whole observation so deeply that the flow तुमको लगता है वो है concept.
But the pond is flow कर रहा है. It's flowing.
It's only a visual concept. It things are arising, molecules are arising, passing away, arising, passing away. And that's how they go. That's so the explanation which is given is they arise and then pass away and then arise at the next place. So it gives the appearance of flow. Just as light, if it goes at one place and arises at another, it gives the appearance of flow. So that's how it is explained. Fire element, of course, if this is slow, this is basically Ayurveda also. They are all in consonance with Ayurveda. So if fire element is low, then digestion will be poor and then become weak. And if it is too high, then you are in bed with fever. Then there is wind element. This, its main characteristic is movement, pushing and supporting, distension, motion. And you know there are various kinds of winds which go on in the body due to various reasons. This is all bodily movements are made possible by wind. Made में MAD रह गए, E हट गया. So finally corrected. So the explanation of Vayu Dhatu also is very interesting. I'll just read out for you. Momentary material dhammas have no time to move from one point to another in space. Just arising passing. They disappear wherever they appear. Therefore, the motion came to be redefined to mean arising of momentary material dhammas in adjacent locations. That is how we bat hai na. A chain over neon signs, bulbs ki. और वो एक के बाद एक जलने का ऐसा लगता है ऐसा मूवमेंट दिस ऑल दे डिफाइन द मूवमेंट सो इट इज एन अपीयरेंस ऑफ मोशन सो देयरफॉर इट इज सेड इफ यू पेनिट्रेट डीपर दैट एयर एलिमेंट इज नॉट मोशन बट इट कॉज ऑफ अराइजिंग ऑफ धम्मास इन द एडजेसेंट लोकेशन व्हिच गिव्स द अपीयरेंस ऑफ मोशन दिस ऑल द डीपर एक्सप्लेनेशन दैट गिवन इन द लिटरेचर सो दीज आर द four great elements and generally to explain it is said our bodies or any matter has its foundation the earth element which serves as the basis for all other elements it is held together by cohesion of water element and maintained by fire element the fire element digests and creates newer matter and so on and it is made mobile by wind element and therefore all the four need to be in balance if they are not in balance the health will not be good. So to ensure health of the body, all the four elements should be are essential. And they depend on physical and also mental factors. And therefore, there is always a relationship of mind and climate and food to the health. So this is the four great elements are understood. And in terms of the outside the body, it is said if these four elements are not in balance, it will cause irregularity in the natural cycles, weather, atmosphere, the storms, and sea things. You know, excess of wind element will cause a storm. Excess of fire element will cause what we experienced last few days. So that's how the explanations are given in this domain. So these are the four. Great Mahabhuta, and there are other concretely produced matter which are concrete, which are actual elements. So then there are sense field matters.
I have changed the order in which it is given there because I felt that would be easier to understand. So the four sense field matters are the four objective phenomena associated with senses. Now with eyes there is a visible object, ear there is sound, with nose there is smell, with tongue there is taste, and with touch there are tangible objects. But say these tangible objects are not independent. So they are defining us elements as those which are irreducible. So the tangible object actually consists of combination of earth, fire and winter. They said that cannot be called as another element. So therefore only four objective phenomena are defined.
Then what happens to the feeling of touch?
That is it, resulting from combination of earth, fire and wind. It is not an independent thing, like sound is different, sight is different, smell is different, the taste is different, touch is somehow not different, it is a combination of other factors. So that's the...
Doesn't feel like that, doesn't feel like the combination of any of those rules,
when you see bodily sensations, what do you feel? Either heaviness, or vibration, or heat, or tingling. They're all made up of that. Yeah. I mean, there's a bad jam. Kya message ho raha? Haripan message ho raha? Yahan pe movement message ho raha? Movement is predominance of Vayu Dhatu, as in this is predominance of Prithvi Dhatu. Heat lag rahi hai, ya cold lag raha hai, predominance of Tejo Dhatu. सो जो भी टेंजिबल ऑब्जेक्ट के हमारे को एक्सपीरियंस है वो इसी तीन कैटेगरी का है. दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज डिफाइंड इन दिस मैनर. इज देयर एनीथिंग एल्स वी एक्सपीरियंस? जस्ट सी, जस्ट लुक बैक एंड सी एट दिस मोमेंट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. इज देयर एनी एक्सपीरियंस व्हिच इज अदर देन दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स? All the bodily experience are of these.
So you can give me then boils down to only two. Earth and fire.
Wind is there, no? Moment for you.
Earth, fire and wind.
Yeah. Moments are happening.
But water we cannot experience.
That's why, to make things absolutely structured and clear, said. You can try and verify if you get any other experience. And since our analysis is of experience, so this is it. They are not saying this is the final reality and nature of truth and all. They are telling the idea. They don't have the idea of telling you this. The idea of ultimate nature of experience. So it's not like metaphysics, ultimate nature of the world.
But it says that externally mein to water exists karta hai. Externally mein to.
Wo dikhta hai.
Nahi sir, agar flow nahi bhi kar raha to water to exist karta hai.
Kaise exist karega? Pata kaise chalega? Uthaoge to bhari pan lagega. Touch karoge to thanda lagega. To softness lagega. Lekin kyunki fluidity hai, apparent hai, to isliye usko diye. Aur uska main जो मेन उसका एक्सपीरियंस के हिसाब से नहीं बट मैटर के एग्जिस्टेंस के हिसाब से आवश्यक है. कोहिजन जोड़ता सकती है, जोड़ने वाली कोई चीज़ नहीं है इन बाकी में, अर्थ में, एयर में, फायर में जोड़ने वाली चीज़ें नहीं, इसलिए उसको एक एलिमेंट मान दिया गया. पीपल आर नॉट हैप्पी विद दिस. Then the next one is life phenomena. Quite obvious.
Things are obvious, means it's a mushkil.
Jire.
See the interesting thing, they have defined life faculty for matter as different and for mind, you remember? Vatati jivit indriyati, nine vavi. So, and here the difference is, this life faculty is present only in sentient beings, not in inanimate matter. So that is the distinction in this moment. What is its jivit indriyas characteristic?
So, jo innate matter mein life phenomena hota, usko kya bolte hain sir? Isko jivit
life phenomena nahi hai.
ये तो जीवित इंद्रिय है
जो जैसे प्लांट्स है प्लांट्स में जीवित इंद्रिया है पत्थर में नहीं माउंटेन में नहीं सो एंड इट्स कॉल्ड अ फैकल्टी बिकॉज़ इट इज अ डोमिनेटिंग इन्फ्लुएंस ये नहीं होगा तो सब कहाँ निकलता सो इट्स इट कॉल्ड ये जीवित इंद्रिया बाकी उनको तो धातु का इंद्रिय का मतलब डोमिनेंट इट परमिएट्स द होल ऑफ द बॉडी That means finished. My faculty is no longer operating.
But sir, then how is मुझे जिसको सबसे सारा confusion होता है कि what is death? Because क्या brain dead death होता है, heart को रुकना death होता है, एक बार recover करके doctor से revive भी कर लेते हैं. So how does that relate to the जीवित इंद्रिया?
It means when it is absence forever. It may be absence for a few moments hoti hai because it's a faculty which arises, passes away. Hota hai ye na. So agar wo kuch moments tak body chalti hai, but when it is finished forever, that's why it is a dumb finished forever. It doesn't arise again. Because according to them, even life faculty is arising, passing. Humko aisa lagta na continuously hai. There it is arising, passing, arising at a very rapid rate, so rapid that It doesn't really matter. And obviously it is the different from the psychic faculty. It maintains the mental states and things like that.
Nutritional phenomena is the nutritive essence of edible foods which maintain the growth of new matter in our body.
There is some blood trying to ask some questions. No question.
So, everything it is a green pure octet kalapa or sukaya, but the kalapa is less rare. Explain here because of the importance of that.
The questions are any relationship between quarks or quantum physics and the four elements earth, water.
Your guess is as good as mine. Quarks ke bhi to naam ajeeb ho gareeb hai unke, there's no idea charm and this and up and down and this and that. It's all their fantasies, I would say. And the interesting thing is, their quarks are also six and they are always existing together, they can't exist separately. Yahan pe kalapa mein eight elements are, they always exist together. So in fact, one of the Nobel laureates called it, he wrote a paper on eightfold path and matter. Glenn Murray ka paper tha, was very famous. He said it almost of that kind.
Darkest question.
And another question is that jivit indriya is a continuation from parents or from mind.
Kamma. It is a faculty which arises out of our own kamma. And that's why it is fixed. At the time of our birth, how much of jivit indriya life faculty is arising is based on our past kamma. So, and it maintains that kamma produced matter which is arising.
But then the question is that the jivit indriya which we just talked, how does that originate versus the jivit indriya which we talked right
in the mind.
In the mind.
Yeah. This jivit indriya supports that. If the body is dead, mind cannot exist. Mind may get blank, but body may still exist. This is the supporting part.
So who comes first? That question arises.
They arise simultaneously. So that is the question of what happens at that. So the as I put down in notes, every being's life is maintained by this karma-produced life faculty. When it terminates, we say the being dies and its body is said to be corpse.
ये दोनों जगह कैसे आ गए, यूनिवर्सल मेंटल फैक्टर में भी और यहाँ रूप में भी?
वहाँ पे तो दूसरी है ना, वो सेम ही नाम सेम है, जीवित इंद्रिया, बट दैट इज साइकिक मैटर. दिस इज द लाइफ फैकल्टी विच सपोर्ट्स द बॉडी, दैट इज द लाइफ फैकल्टी विच सपोर्ट्स द मेंटल एक्टिविटी. तो देखो रिकॉग्नाइज दे आर द पॉसिबिलिटी कि मेंटल एक्टिविटी खत्म भी हो सकती है, बंदा फिर भी चल रहा है, जैसे कोमा में चला गया है, ब्रेन डैमेज हो गई, लेकिन मर नहीं रहा है. सो दे कुड रिकॉग्नाइज द पॉसिबिलिटी,
बट द अदर वे अराउंड इज नॉट पॉसिबल.
द पर्सन्स हार्ट इज फिनिश्ड, इज फिनिश्ड.
इसलिए अदर वे अराउंड का और तरीका नहीं है करने का. बॉडी नहीं है, इसी का फिगर आउट
है. बॉडी में जीव जिंदा नहीं है, बट माइंड कहीं एग्जिस्ट कर सकता है बिना जीव जिंदा के.
उसका तो फॉर्म तो है नहीं, फॉर्मलेस चीज़ों को कैसे पता चलेगा.
जितने
जो नियर डेथ एक्सपीरियंसेस वाले हैं वो इसी तरह कंफ्यूजन क्रिएट कर देते हैं ना, कि अभी हम देख के आए हैं, ये हुआ है, वो पता नहीं क्या हुआ. नेवर नो.
द सुधाकर इज सेइंग दैट सो कम्मा हैज फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट गोइंग फ्रॉम वन बॉडी टू अनदर.
या दैट विल कम more detail. Yeah, that is true, of course. That will come together when we discuss about the mind processes as application of all that. But that is true. Immediate responses, of course. The karma which arises at the time of death, just before death, that determines the next pratisandhi citta, citta which will arise, which is the linking consciousness. Sankhara Bhatya Vinyana. Sankhara which arises just before death will cause the next Vinyana to arise. And that next Vinyana arises because this body is finished. Jivitindriya has gone away. So it cannot sustain. So that next consciousness arises in the next body. So that carries all the signature of all the karma which is held in the mind stream. Carries it together to the next.
But sir, how do we attribute increase of population?
You say that it is because there are billions of non-human existences going on. Humans becoming animals and animals becoming humans is a common phenomenon according to the Buddhist lore.
So does it mean that the total number is constant?
Unanswerable questions. For that you'll have to contact a Buddha. No answer. And you say to me, kya prefer?
He would say that.
Why are you interested in this?
Sir, Amit has a question. Implication of the knowledge of the four elements for our meditation practice?
There is a four element practice in Satipatthana. Because that basic idea is to disperse the feeling of solidity. No? I am. The biggest attachment is with the body. And if you see a body, we are aati aati rati, kabhi kuch uthta hai, kabhi kuch uthta hai, toh hai kya usko kuch nahi. So you then begin to see the attachment to body is like being attached to electron. Aajkal ki bhasha mein agar kahein. So, किससे अटैच हो रहे हैं? So that basically the whole idea of all this exercise is to deconstruct the notion of individuality at various levels. At body. Very broad. So जो हमारे वृत्तिपठान में तो आता है ना, धातु मनसिकार बद्धम. So that is exactly what it is being done. Then we talk of Yes, I read something. It is partially correct. I mean, at this stage it is correct, then we'll amend it later. So I'll just say then वहाँ पे देखे ना universal characteristic. So I put down. Normally वो ऐसा लिखते नहीं है, but मुझे लगा हमारे समझ के लिए अच्छा रहेगा. So there are universal Brahman which are present in all matter. So we should know. Four great elements and four types of derived rupa. That is color, smell, taste, nutrients. So these eight dhammas form what is called a kalapa.
So what is last one? Nutritive.
Nutritive essence. भोजन के अंदर जो तत्व है जो न्यूट्रिशन देता है विच सपोर्ट्स द ग्रोथ ऑफ न्यू मैटर सो इन ऑल थिंग्स इज न्यूट्रिटिव एसेंस इज ऑलवेज इन ग्रोथ ऑफ न्यू मैटर सो दीज एट धर्मास फॉर्म व्हाट इज कॉल्ड ऑक्टेट कलाप आठ अष्ट कलाप होते हैं दे आर दिस एंड दे आर इनसेपरेबल एंड राइज एंड सीज टुगेदर जस्ट एज देयर वी हैड यू नो यूनिवर्सल mental factors, so similarly these you can say. So they are the basic constituents of inanimate matter.
So Ashtakalap is the word.
And they are the basic constituents of inanimate matter. When it is animate matter, there is one more thing added, Jeevitindriya. So in animate matter, there will be always nine elements. Minimum, then there will be others also, out of the other which we will study. So this is how the explanation is given. So written here the notes if you read. In modern physics, the basic building blocks of matter are quarks. There are six quarks. Their names are up, down, strain, charm, top, bottom. These are what they are in classic. And the six corresponding empty quarks. So they ultimately say there are these 12 things which build up the whole universe. So here they are saying there are eight. Then we come to the sensitive phenomena, the senses which we have, five senses, I think we know. Now we can identify what does a whole sensitive phenomena will mean. There will be nine elements in it. The five sense bases, because it is sensitive phenomena means only sentient beings. So nine basic elements and one sensitive phenomena. So when you say eye sensitive, there are 10 constituents. Similarly, nose sensitivity, ear sensitivity. There are 10 dhammas which are building together to constitute that eye sensitivity. So the balance of these 10 things will enable us to see or hear or smell. Anything goes wrong, there will be a problem. And the ability will be impaired or completely done away with. Agar eye sensitivity nahi hai, toh.
So eye sensitivity mein smell ka kya role hoga?
Haan, nahi hai. Wo those elements are present always. Earth, air, fire, water are always present.
This is fine.
And four lower characteristics are also present. The characteristics of the senses, four of them. Color is always present, smell. Any matter will have certain color, will have certain smell, will have certain taste, and some nutritive essence. Which we did. Any matter. So that's how it is seen. But any matter will have these four characteristics. If the eye sensitivity is present, then eye will operate and will be able to see. Similarly, if nose sensitivity and so on. So they actually are said to constitute 10 elements. So this is a word how it is described. And eye sensitivity does not mean eye. I think we have discussed it earlier. It means the sensitive matter behind the retina, which in modern science you will say which convert the signal received under the retina into electrical signal. So that you will call as eye sensitive.
So Sudhakar has a question. A blind person is missing his eye sensitivity.
Yes, sir. And a person who is seeing it very poorly, eye sensitivity faculty will be, or there is an imbalance in other. तो बाकी एलिमेंट्स में भी इंबैलेंस हो जाएगा तो देखने में दिक्कत हो जाती है ना कई बार यू सी मेनी टाइम्स बिकॉज ऑफ सम बॉडीली इंबैलेंस पर्सन इज नॉट एबल टू सी क्लियर देन दिस ऑब्जेक्टिव मटेरियल फिनोमेना दिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑलरेडी
Then we come to the sexual phenomena, this femininity and masculinity, they are also independent matter, which give the characteristic of male and female. Then we come to the heart phenomena, which is a very contentious subject, because probably different of views in literature. No? Those so called Hridayavatthu. They said that Hridayavatthu or heart base, just as there is eye base, there is a heart base. It's not heart. The heart base, where the thoughts reside, where the mind operates from. It is support for mind element and mind consciousness. So it is heart base declared will be, there will be all other mind plus heart base will be there. So then that is the constitution of the heart base.
So this heart base will be
seat of mind. It is said to be the seat of
mind. Or just tarah se hum aajkal use karte hain. Emotions, seat of emotions.
It is, it is a kind of again one of the, they say for most of us it is a kind of a inference. Because you have said emotion and your heart will feel it. So you said that, yeah, think is the heart seat of the whole. This is the way we understand and explain.
Yeah.
So it's a point for me. There's a kind of यहाँ पे कहते हैं सोलर प्लेक्सस जिसे वो लोग कहते हैं सो दिस इज सम रीजन वेयर इट इज सेड टू बी द हार्ट व्हेन यू मेडिटेट डीपली वी नो व्हेन यू पुट अटेंशन देयर द थॉट्स बिगिन टू कम वेरी रैपिडली बट वेदर इट इज रियली सम स्टोरेज देयर और नॉट स्टोरेज का भी कांसेप्ट ही नहीं है इट इज अराइजिंग एंड पासिंग अवे ऑल द टाइम
थॉट्स को दिमाग माइंड में आते
हैं वो अराइज पास अवे होते हैं ना वो लगता है कि हम टू स्टोर द वो शेन जो हमारी मेंटल स्ट्रीम में स्कोर्ड उनका इंपैक्ट
इसलिए हार्ट बेस का कॉन्सेप्ट तो सिर्फ अभी रमा नहीं हमारे इसमें भी है ना रमन महर्षि भी बहुत बोलते थे
हाँ तो जानता हूँ भी यहाँ पर भी से इट इज इन द हार्ट दैट एवरीथिंग इज स्कोर्ड सो इट इज समथिंग व्हिच प्रोबब्ली वी ऑल एक्सपीरियंस बट मॉडर्न साइंस डज नॉट दैट इज अ ट्रब दे डोंट से कि हार्ट में क्या है कुछ भी तो नहीं है ये फालतू में बता रखा है यहाँ पे कुछ है
सर मॉडर्न साइंस का जो हार्ट है वो तो अलग है
हाँ और जो वो सटल चीज है जो हार्ट सटल चीज है ना हार्ट बेस इज अ सटल थिंग और दैट दे कांट रियलाइज तो वो कहा जाता है कि अच्छा ब्लड के अंदर ही है नहीं वो तो ऑर्गन है ना उनके हिसाब से
हार्ट वगैरह कोई ऑर्गन
फिजिकल ऑर्गन है ना तो हार्ट का नाम ऐसे दिया गया ना तो वो जो Even these chakra is the issue. It is not in a modern science is not in a position to figure out ki kya hota.
Modern science isko chakras ko some
nerve centers,
nerve centers in the spinal cord to bolti hu.
Haan, but heart base ka kuch clear nahi hai. Yahan pe mujhe malum pada hai ki heart base ke bare mein koi clarity nahi hai. Even in surprisingly in the original Abhidhamma this is not found. Heart base is not found. There are only 27. It is added in the commentary literature.
So Siddhartha has a question. What explains the lack of sweetness after a few sips of chai?
Say it again.
What explains the lack of sweetness after few sips of chai?
That is basically a relative effect. You take very high sweet, then the tongue gets coated with the same thing as going from sun to shade. Yeah? Weather is not changed, but the effect is reduced. Because this tongue sensitivity gets biased, in a way you can say, so perceives it wrong. The thing which is troubling scientists is, I've tried to write it down somewhere. There are cases of heart transplant recipients which inherit the characteristics of the donor. So, वो उनको समझ नहीं आया ये क्या हो गया? आजकल heart transplant होने लग गया ना? तो जो donor था, उसके जो mental states थी, वो उसमें somehow recipient में आने लगे, तो वो confused हैं क्या हो रहा है? तो heart में है क्या कुछ? ये confusion हो गया science में. So, I found it interesting. So, मैंने चलो उसको भी I put down in notes some of these things. I'm not reading out all of them.
So in Abhidhamma they talk of 27, but in some interior literature they have put 28. Vishuddhi Magama basically. So it is a, you know, the location of the heart base is kind of inferred. But maybe some people might be able to figure it out. I don't know. At least the literature says it is inferred. देर इज ए फिजिकल बेस, ये बात तो आती है पठान, बट क्या है वो नहीं लिखा हुआ. तो कमेंट्रीज में कहा गया है कि वो हृदय वृत्ति. दैट्स हाउ इट इज कम टू रिकॉग्नाइज.
सो हृदय वृत्ति इज नॉट पठान में एज अ
27 ही एलिमेंट्स
में. अच्छा 28 है नहीं.
अभी धम्म पिटक में 27 एलिमेंट्स, दे बिकेम 28 इन पाली कमेंट्रीज. So in the same manner, just as we identify these octards, we can identify other, you know, octards and this hearing and seeing and all other elements. I've just put them down for somebody if you're interested. We don't want to get into details of that. I've just put them down. So you can study them later. So what are the general comments on this? Let's come to that. The five sensitivities, the gender phenomena, the heart base and life faculty originate due to karma performed in previous lives. This I have added for the sake of clarity. And these, all these concretely produced matter are dhammas, they are real dhammas. They are not nominal things, they are not concepts. They have an intrinsic nature. They have the characteristic of anicca, dukkha, anatta. They are directly produced by conditions such as kamma, consciousness, temperature, nutriment. They are all subject to change and they can be comprehended by insight knowledge. So this is how they are called concretely produced matter. The why we are discussing it is because there are non-concretely produced matter also.
This is a bit when we say that the karma produced in the previous lives, so the karma produced in the previous lives gives rise to
first matter which arises at the birth.
So karma produces matter.
Yeah, mind produces matter. Oops. That we'll see further also. We'll discuss in more. The matter originate kaise hota hai? Karma is one of the, for living being, karma is the most prominent thing. Food is secondary. Temperature is another thing. Temperature hota hai tabhi food digest hoga, the matter produces. Otherwise, for living beings, karma is the prominent thing, which relinks the past life and new life. At that time, mind produces matter. Sankara pachya vinyana, vinyana pachya nama rupa. Nama rupa agya na, nama bhi hai, rupa bhi agya.
Nama is mind.
Various mental factors. So why we are discussing, as I said, there are non-concretely produced matter which are actually attributes. So as I have written there, if you see that transition slide, they are mere attributes of Pishlivari slide. They are mere attributes of concretely produced matter. So they are not classified as ultimate realities and cannot become the object of meditation. They are nominal things, but classified as parts of Rupa because of their great importance. They are therefore called sometimes nominal Rupa, the attributes. So what are these? First is space element, which is a very surprising thing to see. That space element is seen as a non-concretely, of course it is non-concretely, but it is not seen as a in the Abhidhammic literature, it is not seen as a fundamental dhatu like earth, air, fire, water. They say it essentially is a void region which delimits them, separates the various kalapas. So there are various kalapas and there is a void in between them, and that we call, for the sake of understanding, as a space element.
So this is different than say Arvida. Arvida is space kalapas.
रोल काफी ज्यादा है, गिवन है इक्वल इंपॉर्टेंस टू एयर फायर वाटर, बट इट इज सेड दैट इट हैज इट्स ओन नेचर, स्वभाव नहीं है सर इट्स वेरी प्रोमिनेंट, इट हैज इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ कोर्स, इट हैज इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस इन दिस ऑल्सो, बिकॉज इफ देर इज नो स्पेस बिटवीन यू कॉन्ट ब्रेक एनीथिंग एंड गेट इट इन टू पार्ट्स, अगर स्पेस ही ना हो तो कैसे निकलेगा वैसे, the very fact that there is a space between atoms means you can break it and get into parts, so it has great importance, but they don't classify it as dharma because there is no characteristics, so koi swabhav hi nahi hai, so that is the main reason, it is neither of the nature of materiality nor of its own characteristics, so there delimitation of matter, so only as a mat convention it is presented as a conditioned dharma. So it is actually a conceptual construct. So what is it saying? There are so many rupa kalapas in our body. How do we distinguish between them? Because there is space. So it has a great importance. But unfortunately, you can't call it anything. That is the reason. So it is due to space element that lumps of stone and metal can be broken or cut into pieces. So then there are intimating material phenomena, or we can say communication. And you know, there are two types of communication, bodily as well as verbal. So they are also identified as attributes. But they are seen not as independent. They arise because of various elements operating together. So bodily intimation is through nodding, bending the arm, moving the hand, going forward, so as to reveal our intention to others. And verbal is of course through words we speak out. In each of these cases, various kalapas arise. Bodily movement means when will arise, and all those kind of, the speaking will mean earth element. Right? So sound is earth element will be there. Sound is the object. So elemental will be arising through the, so the earth element is seen to be an important element in verbal intimation. So then they explain in full detail, you know. When a thought arises that I want to speak, then it sets up, that thought sets up material phenomena. And that will cause earth element to rise and get into throat and then words will come out. That's how it is explained. If the consciousness originated earth element arises while impinging the physical apparatus and that produces the vocal sound. Similarly, when you want to think, I want to move, then that consciousness, or that intention of moving produces wind element. And that causes the movement. This is how these intimations are explained. Then we have mutable material phenomena, those properties of lightness, malleability, and dimming, which we have discussed in mind, same properties in matter also exists. So they are of importance. For us, from the point of view of health disposition. If the body is rigid and you are ill, some problem is there. So it says the balance of all these three characters, neither it should be so malleable ki hile ja rahi hai, so physical dystrophy ho jati hai na muscles mein, tik hi nahi rahe wo phale ja rahe. So that is the imbalance of these qualities which is responsible for different kinds of illnesses associated with the bodily malfunction. So when the great elements are in balance, then they appear, and then you have better health and pleasant disposition. And then lastly, there are these four characteristics of matter, that is production, continuity, decay, and importance. First to deal with the birth, the other to deal with the decay and death. In plants, instead of four, it is said there are five. Because production takes place in two stages. First is the seed to sprout, and then is the sprout to the seed germinating, and then is the sprout forming.
Seed to grow a different sheet from the.
They say that this is what is happening there. In other cases, in human beings that doesn't happen. In birds also production is at two stages. Egg is produced, then the bird appears. In mammals it doesn't happen. That's all it is said. Maybe because of that. I think we know about all this stuff, right? decay and impermanence you are feeling all the time. Then you come to the general comments on matter. You are at the case where you are at the case. So the comments which are kind of subtle about that is, unlike individual consciousnesses which can only arise one at a time, many particles can arise within our body at the same time. The body is a collection of rupa kalapas arising and passing away at a tremendous speed. And unlike consciousness, matter is rootless. Mental states have a root, wholesome or unwholesome. There's nothing like that, nor wholesome or unwholesome. And it arises with four causes, just as other things arise. There are so many universal factors which give rise to various things. Similarly, here also there are certain universal factors. Four basic Mahabhuta, and then they are derived from this. Next, you can just go.
So, Silesh has a question. If mind body is interconnected, why is it rootless? It means no karma.
The mind and body influence each other, but it is rootless in the sense that matter does not have any thing other than the, just as there are roots of craving, aversion, and delusion. There, which has very strong effect and hold on to the mental states. Here, there are no such things. So that is why it is said to be rootless. Okay. Next question.
So this one also.
Then there are, matter can be an object of defilement, you know that. Then we can get attracted towards various kinds of matter. And it pertains to sense sphere, it does not exist in the other Rupa Brahma Loka and Arupa Brahma Loka. This sense sphere matter that we are talking about. The Chitta can move an object, matter cannot move. Quite obvious. Though it may have life activity, still it cannot know. It doesn't have the ability to know. Cognition ability. And it's not something like defilements which can be eradicated. Can't eradicate. Conservation of matter, so to say, is it arises, passes away, arises, passes away. Then what are the causes of origination of matter? So this is what we are mentioning earlier also. The four causes are there: karma, consciousness, fire, tejo, dhatu, and nutriment. I think we can easily understand this. All of the karma produced matter which arise from volitions of 12 unwholesome chittas, 8 create unwholesome chittas, 5 fine material chittas, all the chittas you just take, they all can produce matter correspondingly of various kinds. And it is this karma which determines the sex, the lifespan, the health, the temperament, physical appearance of a human being in conformity with the deeds done in the past. So that's time relinking what is going to really determine the starting consciousness and the starting health. मतलब कोई बच्चा मान लीजिए पैदा होता है जिसमें कुछ फिजिकल डिफेक्ट है. सो इट इज सीन टू बी इन दिस थॉट प्रोसेस, इट इज सीन टू बी रिजल्ट ऑफ पास्ट somebody's eyes are not there, somebody's hands are not there, or whatever is the problem, it seems to be a result of past karma. Then we know consciousness, we already studied various kinds of chitta, so they'll produce matter in appropriate kalapas according to the nature of consciousness. Sometimes earth element will be more, or this element will be more, and therefore accordingly the impact of the consciousness on the body will be different. So this, for example, intention to move, as I said, it creates more of a vayu dhatu. Intention to speak creates more of earth dhatu, prithvi dhatu. And when we get angry, tejo dhatu arises. So you can see, we can know that that can be system. When we practice loving kindness, mind gets calm and quiet. This cold element, so to say, and it restores the balance between then between an angry mind and calm mind. That's the kind of difference which arises. The fire element is one of the most important in producing matter, which you know, digestion and production of matter. And it is said to be also equally important in non-sentient beings. Here there is an interesting thing. The trees are not supposed to be conscious beings. They have a life faculty. But of the matter kind, they don't have a life faculty of the mind kind. So they don't think, they don't have consciousness, so they have life faculty. So that's the distinction that has been made.
But so trees also have responded to, in many experiments, to emotions and...
Yeah, there have been experiments on that kind. And what they say, what the Abhidhamma basically says that is the effect of external matter on the...
emotions
matter
are
created by emotions.
Rupa.
Matter created by emotion is affecting me. That's what I think is... It's not, I didn't get any explanation of it. So because what they say is that they don't have consciousness and so they are not part of cycle of birth and death.
So trees are not part of cycle of birth.
They say that in the, in some cases where the example, the reasoning is given, which may sound very funny, is that the effect which they have given of the plant's influence, the emotion, loving kindness, and things of that kind, it is because there are Rukh Devdas living in the tree. And they feel happy and therefore they plants life response to that. There's no kind of explanation available in the literature. But one thing becomes clear, the difference between meat and vegetables becomes clear. We used to say loosely, na, trees are also conscious, animals are also conscious, kya farak hai? The difference in consciousness. They are physically conscious but not mental. There's no mind in the tree. In the animal there's a mind, there's a consciousness of that or of mind. So when you distinguish between consciousness and life faculty, then there's difference between them. So there is a physical life faculty, but mental life faculty. So that way there's a difference between trees and plants and the non-sentient matter is, of course, means there's no life faculty at all. Stone and mountain. Then the last reason for origination of matter is, of course, nutrient. It's quite obvious. Nutrition for all the beings. And as in case of any other dhamma, where more than one cause, so many dukkhas can be produced. So it's not one cause producing one, if you already studied in the basic characteristic. So the lady said, oh, you very beautiful analogy to explain all these factors together. She says physical body is like a tree, kamma is like the seed, fire element is like the earth which supports the tree,
Nutritive essences like the rain water which falls regularly, keep the regularly, वो continuously चाहिए होता है, बीच बीच में चाहिए. And mind is like the atmosphere and the sun which support it from outside. So it's a beautiful analogy given by Lady Sahib. बहुत अच्छा लगा. You know, it gives you clarity of the role of, because from the seed, tree, you can easily understand. So Kamma is like the seed, basic. Origin to वहीं से शुरू होगा. And fire element is the support. Keeps on giving support. And भोजन है वो पानी की तरह, बीच बीच में चाहिए, उसके बगैर कोई काम नहीं चलेगा. Mind is like the atmosphere and the sun which supports it from outside.
So he's saying dead meat is devoid of both physical and mental jivitendriyas.
Yeah, that is true. So animals, between animals and plants, distinction between animals and plants.
Difference between animals and plants.
Animals mein chitta hai, plants mein chitta nahi.
But sir, once what God Sudhakar is saying, the meat is
dead. Already dead, yeah. Already dead.
That's true.
But what is the benefit of this? No, finally, you have some other distinction. I'm not thinking of getting out of it. So I think probably I should have written between animals and food. And it's going to become a difference between meat and vegetables. I should have written difference between animals and vegetables. That would have been a better statement. So, I have to correct it.
So, what is Sudhakar saying? But plant has physical jivitindriya.
Animals and plants, yeah. Yeah, so to that extent, because, but they don't have any possibility of mental pain being felt and things of that kind. So, the extent of violence, if you want to say, is much lesser in that sense. That's why the Buddha never advised people to cut the trees or do anything. In the very famous time, you know, when monk had gone to a forest, oh, paid for branches, darkness, and he said, I'm going to keep that for now. So the Rukh Devta, who was in the forest, said, what are you doing? I'm going to keep that for now. और मॉन्स आते हैं वो भी करते हैं तो परेशान देन गोस टू बुद्धा एंड टेल देम देखो क्या कर रहे तुम्हारे मॉन्स एंड बुद्धा टू कॉल्स देम एंड टेल देम देन डू बिजनेस
सर सुधाकर्स कंटिन्यूड क्वेश्चन इज वेयर इज दिस प्योरिटी एंड इम्प्योरिटी विद रिगार्ड टू फूड कम्स फ्रॉम
इट इज basically the volition. That's why Buddha said, for monks, eat jo milna kha lo. But agar tumhare kehne pe koi, tumne kaha ki mujhe wo acha lagta aur wo khaya, unko diya ja raha aur kisi animal ko maar ke, to tumhare naam chalega. So that becomes because you're then eating things out of taste and destroying life with
other things. But then, sir, if it means ki, if there's a buffet, आप वहाँ पे वेजिटेरियन खा रहे हो और नॉन वेजिटेरियन खा रहे हो तो उसका कोई फर्क नहीं होगा.
अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस यस अकॉर्डिंग टू बुद्धा इट डोंट मैटर बिकॉज़ यू आर नॉट ऑर्डर
तो नॉर्मली फिर किसी डेली लाइफ में लोग खाते हैं नॉन वेज तो फिर फूड मार्केट क्यों नहीं है.
हाँ इसीलिए तो दिस बट लेटर ऑन महायाना में इसको चेंज कर दिया गया कि हम डाइट खाने से डायरेक्टली तो नहीं मार रहे बट वी आर रविदशील की बात जो है वी आर इन्हें गए इनडायरेक्टली एनकरेजिंग पीपल टू किल सो वी शुड अब्सटेन सो एंड इवन इन बुद्धा टीचिंग यू फाइंड दैट यू नो फॉर हाउस होल्डर्स किलिंग एनिमल्स वाज नॉट सपोज्ड टू बी डन इवन रियरिंग एनिमल्स फॉर स्लॉटर वाज सीज टू बी अ रॉन्ग लाइवलीहुड सो कंसिडरिंग द होल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सोसाइटी द शीलास वर डिवाइज्ड इन दैट मैनर दैट स्लोली पीपल शुड मूव इन दैट डायरेक्शन. So Mahayana people have therefore moved in that direction.
So what is the origination of Chitta and Chetsika? And let's read further. Three things are needed: past karma, basis to depend upon, and an object. The basis is provided by the body, and object is the external, whichever arises. So the analogy again same thing. First is like a seed, the basis is like earth, and object is like the rain. Same thing I have just redefined with respect to Chitta and Chetsika.
So Amit has a question. In buffet, we don't eat non-veg. The lesser demand will discourage others to kill animals in future.
Yes, that is the logic being used in Mahayana streams. Therefore, we should avoid. But then there is the other problem that the monks are supposed to eat whatever they get. So there is a kind of conflict between two conflicting requirements. So Buddha choose the one. Monks go to selection. That's why householders in advice was very clear.
अगर monks को भी selection मिल जाती है, तो जो भी knowledge खाते हैं, तो इसका जो term फल है वो उनको मतलब जितना होता है.
तो तू नहीं खा, तू उस हिसाब से तो नहीं खा रहा. They're not eating it. They're not saying that they are doing it for the animal to be killed for them. It's already there. That is the kind of logic which is used. It can be questioned definitely. Can definitely question, but physically तो clear है कि non-veg खाने से पेट खराब होता है, इसमें कोई doubt नहीं. non-veg खाने से बीमारियाँ होती हैं, इसमें कोई doubt नहीं, वो तो clear है. इसलिए मैं वो Harvard की जो film है, mindful eating वाली, वो अच्छा नहीं खाता होगा.
पशु
की जैसे प्रवृत्ति आती है ना. हाँ, उसका फर्क पड़ता है. The food which you eat, whatever are the kalapas there, that nutritional essence will be of that kind. So that will be the other. Okay, now we come to more difficult things which we'll discuss later. Just mentioning it here. One thing is clear, mind arises dependent on matter, except in the immaterial worlds. Where matter is mind over, except in the Arupa Brahma Loka, just with many models. And there is interdependence of mind and matter. That also is clear. This is the thing which is, you may say, concept. Duration of lifespan of matter is equal to 17 moments of chitta. This they say is what they observe. So it is a kind of experience, not a theory. Another very important thing is consciousness can produce matter, but matter cannot produce consciousness.
ये तो बड़ा यू बोलू कि हम जिस तरह का खाना खाते हैं इस तरह की हमें कॉन्शियसनेस होती है. अगर हम अगर तीखा खाना खाते हैं कॉन्शियसनेस नहीं
उस तरह के सेंसेशन रूप रूप का लाभ उस तरह के जागते हैं. उनके प्रति हम प्रतिक्रिया करते हैं तो फिर उस तरह का हमारा चित्त बनने लगता है. इसलिए अगर आप एक करंट को मिट्टी भी खिला दोगे मिर्ची भी खिला दोगे तो उसको कॉन्शियसनेस खराब नहीं होने वाला. भगवान को तो उन्होंने प्राइट है क्या खिला दिया था राजन सीजन ही खिला दिया डिंट अनसेटल हिम एंड ही गेट वरीड एंड अपसेट. सो इट विल अफेक्ट द बॉडी डेफिनेटली. अगर आप मिर्च वाला खाना खाओगे तो अग्नि धातु जागेगी और दिक्कत होगी. अब उस पर आप प्रतिक्रिया करोगे तो अपना शरीर चित्त खराब होगा. इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डिस्टिंक्शन बिकॉज साइंस ने अभी भी अधिकतर साइंटिस्ट यही मानते हैं कि कॉन्शियसनेस इज प्रोड्यूस बाय ब्रेन एंड द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ ब्रेन. दो इट इज नाउ ब्रेकिंग डाउन देयर इज अ होल रेंज ऑफ साइंटिस्ट हु बिलीव कॉन्शियसनेस इज द फंडामेंटल एलिमेंट. सो यू कैन सी द रिलेशनशिप ऑफ ऑल दैट यू हैव डन टू प्रैक्टिस. या धातु मनसिकार पब्लम सिमिलिया बुचर सेलिंग द मीट. सो ऑल दैट इज बेसिकली टू एक्सप्लेन that various dhatus give right to matter. There is no essence of it. Solidity is only apparent. Then in Dhammanupashana we had ayatan pabham, various ayatans, so you see they are also matter interacting with the external world. So then we had the arising of. So when you say we touch anything, we touch this, we are not touching a matter. Object, you are touching experience. Our experience is hardness, softness, heat, cold, and this. So everything else is a concept. This is a concept
book is a concept, I am a concept, my body is a concept, experience is the reality. So that's how they distinction is made. When in Mahasatipatthana Sutta, you know, we think, you know, the tanha arises at sense doors, and at each sense sphere, and at each sense sphere contact, thoughts are directed to various objects. So all these things we studied in Satipatthana Sutta. So they are all being explained and its root. Sankhara Pachya Vinyanam Jasyamna Parata and Vinyana Pachya Namrupa. So Vinyana se Namrupa Rao. Vinyana ke saath Nam to ho gaya, dusre mental factors, Arup ho gaya, God. Namrupa Pachya Salayatan, six senses, those six senses I described. Salayan Pachya Phasa, Phasa Pachya Vedana, Vedana Pachya Kham.
अगर हम उसमें देखें इस लिंक में हम कितनी बार बिटवीन नाम एंड रूपा एंड कॉन्शियसनेस हम स्विच किए हैं
इट्स नॉट ओनली एट द बर्थ इट्स नॉट ओनली एट द बर्थ दैट
इट्स बट हम रूप टू चित्तस भी आए हैं सर इस लिंक में
इग्नोरेंस की तरह से आए हैं
हम तन्हा पे आ गए
ना जो वेदना थी उससे मेंटल फैक्टर पे माइंड पे फील किया ना Mind feels things, no? Till we have the body and mind to integrated hai hai na? Produced to nahi kar raha na? Uske par interaction kar raha na?
So is the bachya word?
Haan, bachya does not mean produce. Aapko wo bachya is a complicated word. So we baad mein dekhi. Bachya means it depends on wrong. Salatan, bachya, phasya, phasya, bachya, vedana. वेदना पच्चे या तन्हा वेदना पे डिपेंडेंट है तन्हा बट डिपेंडेंट अप्रॉक्सिमेट कॉज क्या है तन्हा का अविद्या अविद्या नहीं होगी तन्हा नहीं जाएगी सो दैट्स हाउ दे द होल चेन गोज ऑन सो वी कैन सी द होल सीक्वेंस सो द मेन मैसेज अकॉर्डिंग टू माय अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन कॉन्सेप्ट एंड रियलिटी बिकॉज़ बॉडी इज सच ए स्ट्रॉन्ग कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी फाइंड इट सो डिफिकल्ट टू गेट आउट ऑफ
So Siddhakar's question, matter arises in non-sentient stuff. Same happens in sentient beings. What exactly production of matter by consciousness mean?
It means that when in non-sentient, I think it will become clear when you see how does matter arise in non-sentient. It arises because of heating, that temperature. Various factors arise and that's how the matter arises. In sentient beings, in addition to those reasons, there is an additional reason of consciousness. It produces. We think something and the body gets caught. Right? So, like in Bhattu is getting stressed. We get angry and this happens. We want to shout and then certain things, changes happen in the body and the sound comes out. So, that's the way. You can easily feel. Your intentions are producing. Intention means sankhara. Sankhara bachya jnana. And jnana bachya nama. This can be easily felt every time it happens. So that is a key thing which you have to see, that distinction between concept and reality. So body is a concept, I am a concept. Everything which we see in the world is a concept. Reality is these dhammas. Chitta, Chetsika, Rupa, they are the realities. Various kinds of things which we are studying. Then we come to the last slide. Next. The first three ultimate truths, Chitta, Chetsika, and Rupa, they form what are merely conventional truths for human being or a Deva. Or these are the realities, other things are appearances. And without this understanding, we remain shackled and bound and trapped. Change like that. I think I have to move in. Baki sab hai ki nahi. Still getting trouble.
And ignorance in turn gives rise to craving. And we live perceiving, thinking and giving body and mind as mine, I, myself, with craving, conceit and wrong views. Such clinging is the truth of suffering. The moment we cling, I am a person, I am a good, handsome person, I am an ugly person, I am heavy, I am fat, I am this, I am that. Just that. So this is what we learn from the fundamentals of all what we have done. Because other than Chitta, Chetsika and Rupa, there is nothing which comes within our experience.
Which I am thinking?
Kundalini, Kundalini.
Green tea, banana, Chitta. Green tea.
So, this concludes our discussion on fundamentals. Then we'll start discussing applications. If you have any questions, our friends have any questions. Deepak has any questions? This whole issue of personhood has to be seen through. It has to be seen through. You can't destroy it. It has to be seen through. And seen through her as a thick edge, a achhi kahani. See through that substantially. The more you see, more you see, more you see, the less trapping. Searching, yay, oh. Slowly gets deep. Baki is the practice. Once you understand the fundamentals, that's the matter of practice. In tune with this fundamental, if you understand thoroughly.
Dagar is saying something in a lighter moment. So he said, got it now, understand what produces chai.
Yes, you're right. Good friends, thank you. See you next time then. Have a great question.
So is global warming also because of mental anger?
Yeah, there are, I didn't add that part, I think in notes mein kahin dala hua hai. There's a sutta of Buddha, you know, when the kings become unrighteous, and the kings become unrighteous, the elements become unbalanced, and then there are famines and droughts and floods and earthquakes and... When it starts from kings and obviously goes on to the subjects, the whole country. But it starts from kings. इसलिए वो एक वहाँ की उस समय भी एक perception था कि अगर drought हो रहा है तो king कहा जाता था भैया किसी शांतवंत को बुला लो. जैसे वो है ना अपना सुत्ता कौन सा chanting जो करते हैं रतन सुत्ता. उसकी story यही है ना रतन सुत्ता की भी कि वैशाली में बिल्कुल अब दुर्भिक्ष आ गया, बुरी हालत हो गई. तो राजा को कहा भैया तुम जाओ भगवान बुद्ध को रिक्वेस्ट करो आए वो तुमको आशीर्वाद दें, यहाँ पे बहुत अधर्म फैला हुआ है इसलिए ये हालत हो रहा है. सो देन बुद्ध कम्स एट हिज रिक्वेस्ट एंड चांट्स द रतन सुत्ता एंड देन द एवरीथिंग इज फिनिश्ड. फैमिन, ड्रॉट, एवरीथिंग गोज, रेन फॉल्स एंड सो दैट्स व्हाई फॉलिंग ऑफ रेन एट अ प्रॉपर टाइम इज सीन टू बी अ वेरी क्रूशियल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ बैलेंस ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ नेचर. Well, it seems like superstition, I didn't discuss it, but that's the way Buddha explained it.
So that was saying that Gringari also mentioned the story in the Granth.
Yeah, one story of that kind of thing. But there's a sutta of that kind. Ratan sutta is chanting as we do it as a regular. So you remember the qualities of Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha, and that clears the kind of obstruction in the mind. I mean, if you take it purely on logic, then also you can understand. And people become greedy, they want more, more production, more goods, more carbon dioxide, global warming. When they become greedy, then there is fear, when there is violence, then there is crime, then there is terrorism. You can see that. When there is delusion, terrorism is a direct cause of relation to delusion. Delusion and poverty, they are two causes of terrorism. You can easily see that. So the fact that elements are getting disturbed is also partly, some would say, substantially, totally because of that reason. At the root cause of the problems lie the three poisons.
Dark vision.
Yes. Greed, hatred and delusion. They are the three things which are creating all the complications which you see today. Whether it is violence or crime or weather change, climate change, everything. The root of that is this. That needs a bit bigger reflection to see that it is true. They would even give an explanation. आप रूप कलाप ऐसे ही पैदा कर रहे हो, अग्नि धातु प्रदेश हो रही है तो गर्मी होगी होगी, तो सारे लोग अगर गुस्से वाले हैं तो सड़क पर सब एक दूसरे को मार ही रहे हैं, तो अग्नि धातु के प्रचलित हो रहा है, वो बढ़े जा रहा है, तो ग्लोबल वार्मिंग ही होगी. दैट्स द अनदर वे ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग फ्रॉम द धातु गंगस परसेप्शन.
Okay. Any other questions?
Thank you.
Any questions?